In this video, we will be going over how to collect saliva samples using the passive drool method. For the passive drool collection, you will need a tube, a straw or a saliva collection aid, a glass of water to rinse out your mouth with, an alcohol swab to wipe down the tube with, and a plastic bag or small box to store your sample in while it is in the freezer. This bag or box should ideally be labeled on the outside with a biohazard label. At least 10 minutes prior to collecting your saliva sample, you must rinse your mouth out with water. You can vigorously swish the water around your mouth as you would with mouthwash before either swallowing it or spitting it out into a cup or sink, depending on what you have available. This will remove any food particles or debris in your mouth and keep it from going into your sample. You should not eat or drink anything else again prior to collecting. If you do, you should rinse your mouth out with water again and wait at least another 10 minutes before collecting your sample. Next, you will select the tube you will collect into. If it has been pre-labeled, make sure that you have selected the correct tube. If you have been given labels to put on the tube, you should select the correct label, peel it off the paper back, and stick it on the outside of the tube on the white patch so that the barcode runs lengthwise on the tube, as you can see in the photo. The label should not go over the cap of the tube or on the volume lines on the tube. Next, you will remove only the cap of the tube and place it on a clean countertop. You can unwrap your straw or saliva collection aid, and with clean hands, place it in the tube. If you are using a straw, you can hold on to it so one end is in the tube and one end is sticking out of the tube for you to spit or drool into. If you were using a saliva collection aid, you should place it so that the ridged end is placed firmly in the tube and the smooth end faces up. These saliva collection aids only allow saliva to flow in one direction, so if you put it in the wrong way, saliva will not go into the tube, but will overflow back out onto the tube. Saliva will start to pool in the bottom of your mouth. Resist the urge to swallow the saliva and instead guide it into the tube with your tongue or by slowly spitting through the straw or saliva collection aid into the tube. Do not blow the saliva into the tube with force, or the saliva could overflow out of the tube or start bubbling up and make it difficult to collect enough saliva in the tube. Any bubbling does not count towards the volume of saliva collected. If you have been told how much saliva to collect, make sure you collect that amount before stopping. If you have not been told how much saliva to collect, you can aim for at least 1 mL, which will be marked as 1.00 on the side of the tube. Do not collect more than the top volume mark of the tube, which is 1.50 mils. Once you reach the amount, you can recap your tube. If you have been given an alcohol swab, you can wipe down the outside of the tube to remove any saliva that may have spilled out onto the sides. The tube should then go back into the labeled plastic bag or box and into a freezer as soon as possible. If you do not have a freezer, you can put it in a fridge, or if that is not available, on ice. And when you have access to a freezer, you should put it in there as soon as you are able to. You should inform your study contact if you cannot freeze the sample and how long it was in the fridge or on ice after collecting it. You can then wash your hands thoroughly. Your collection is now complete. Many people have trouble collecting or collect samples that can affect the test results. Here are a few things to avoid doing prior to collections and a few tips that may help with collections. At least 1 hour before collecting, you should try to avoid eating a large meal, consuming alcohol or dairy products, avoid smoking or using nicotine products, brushing your teeth, or doing any moderate to intense exercise unless you were told to do so by your study contact. If you have done any of these things, just make a note of it and tell your study contact when they collect your samples. If you have trouble collecting, there are a few tricks you can try. You can try to think of your favorite foods, something salty like French fries, or sour like biting into a lemon. This could increase saliva production in your mouth. You can also make gentle chewing motions to simulate eating. Do not bite your gums or mouth to produce more saliva, as that could result in bleeding and affect the results. We hope you have found this video helpful, but please feel free to reach out to your study contact or email us at iisbr@uci.edu with any questions you may have. Thank you.